Number 12, Darren Duncan. Number 15, Quinnell Brown. And number 24, Chris Commons. The official, Tony, actually that was Forrest Sigler who put the ball in the air. Your officials for today, Tony Green, Pat Evans, and Forrest Sigler. Tony Green has officiated 7 Final Fours. So we're underway as it's HBC in the white uniforms. A shot in the paint, no good by Brown. And primetime players in the dark uniforms come away with it. Smith with it. Terrell Smith for the primetime players. We'll play 2 18-minute halves to determine who will move on to the next round as Chris Moore muscles his way in for 2. 6'1" point guard out of Charleston Southern. Pass in the corner to Brown. Brown for 3. That one rims off, but a big offensive rebound. The follow shot no good. Brown's tip no good after the miss by Jeremiah Wilson. And the primetime players come away with it. Had a great game in the previous game, but came right down to the final seconds as this is stolen away by Commons. Chris Commons going in, puts it up and in. Chris Commons, 6'8" power forward out of South Carolina Aiken. Should be familiar with this arena here at Peach Belt Conference, Clayton State University. Shot inside the arc is no good, and the rebound to Darren Duncan. Well, yesterday, primetime players pulled the big upset as that 3 is good by Steph Bode. 5-0 5-2 HBC. 3 ball all the way. That rims out for Terrell Smith. And HBC comes away with it. Duncan into the front court. Duncan kicks it back on the wing. Deflected and stolen by Barnett. But yesterday, primetime pulled the upset of the number 1 seed, Team BDB. Driving in, layup good by Donald Rutherford. That's his first 2 of the game. And in that game, primetime players hit 15 threes in the opening half. They were 15 of 27 from three-point land. This deflected and stolen away, but stolen right back after the steal by Barnett. Brown inside. He'll play unselfish. Dish to his teammate, and the layup good by Jeremiah Wilson. First 2 points of the game for Jeremiah Wilson. And it's 7-4 HBC out in front by 3. Primetime players had a total of 6 players in double figures yesterday. They were led by Donald Rutherford with 20 points. Rutherford was 7 of 15 from the floor, 4 of 9 from 3-point range. Follow away shot, back of the iron, no good. Offensive rebound, the follow shot by Pfaff is no good, but he got fouled, and Thomas Pfaff will shoot 2 shots. Thomas Pfaff, 6'8" power forward out of Lipscomb. Quinnell Brown picks up the personal. That's his first, team first. And Pfaff shooting 2 shots. Pfaff yesterday with just 2 points, 1 of 3 shooting. He had 4 rebounds in the game. Primetime did cool off considerably in the second half, going 0 for 12 behind the arc after 15 for 27 in the first half. Second free throw, Pfaff rolls it in. So for the game, they finished 15 of 39, 38.5%. But that game was over early. They built a 30-point lead, and actually the game ended with a little over 5 minutes to play after so many players were fouling out or being ejected. A shot in the paint, no good by Commons. Here's Moore in the front court. Up top to Smith. They have yet to attempt a 3 yet, as their game plan so far is to work it inside.
Got plenty of time.
Smith inside again. Back out. Top of the key. 3 on the way. Good. Donald Rutherford with 5. First 3 of the game for the primetime players, the 19 seed. Darren Duncan. That shot no good. Tapped out long. And saved to Brown. Brown cut off. Gets it in the corner to Commons. He'll try a 3. And the rebound to Rutherford. yesterday, HBC scored 102 points, a 102-84 win over AMR. And in that victory, they were led by Quinnell Brown, who had 29 points. The putback good. Miss Moore now with four. Bonet for three. Back of the iron, no good. Here come the primetime players back the way. Moore again for two more. 6 foot one, Chris Moore out of Charleston Southern has given the primetime players an early 5-point lead. You can hear a very vocal crowd behind me for the primetime players. A chant of defense. Three ball for the top. No good by Wilson. And the rebound to the primetime players. Barnett quickly in the front court. Barnett passes to the baseline. Deflected out of bounds. Last touch by Duncan.
Hey, shooter.
But in that game yesterday for HBC, Quinnell Brown led the way with 29 points on 9 of 13 shooting, 9 of 9 for the free throw line. Also, Darren Mincy finished with 21 points. They had six players in double figures in scoring their 102 points. And for the game, they shot 54.2% from the floor. Splitting defenders. Sean Barnett lays it in. First two of the game for Sean Barnett. Out of Wingate University. Bonet cut off. Now, here's Smorts. He's also cut off on the baseline. Smorts, 38% three-point shooter from the University of Maryland. Gets it up top, but common shot no good. The follow underneath is good. Well, Brown gets his first 2 points of the game. Under 12 minutes to play. First half action. And the three, good by Rutherford. Back-to-back trays for Donald Rutherford. 17-9, an 8-point lead for the primetime players. Off to a great start. Our second of four bracket championship games. Bonet, reverse layup at Walt County. Stepped on the baseline, out of bounds. Our third game coming up today will be at 2:30. That will be No Excuses, the 23 seed and the 9 seed, John Bell All-Stars.
Let it go, step.
And a try for three, outside good by Chris Moore. 9 first half points for Moore, and it's 20-9 primetime players. Mincy, pass deflected by Foth, and chased down by Moore. Foth, down low, Barnett, missed the layup, the tap around and down. Brown loving it here. Not sure if they're going to give that last tip to Foff or to Moore. I'll give it to Moore, or to Foff rather, until we can get a clarification and a timeout. So let's check in on the primetime players huddle with Chris Thomas.
Huddle with Chris. On that special when Chris can get down and come up. That's what I'm saying. And make sure he can keep hopping on that. Keep playing D. Keep playing D.
Hey, transition. We got to win.
Another fast start for the primetime players as they lead it 22-9, 10:47 to play, opening half. Bonet will bring it up. Steph Bonet out of LIU Post. Commons. Lob pass. Gets it over to Brown. Brown saves it off of the primetime players. So we'll remain with HBC. Brown looks back door, nothing there. Gets it to Bonet, follow away shot, no good. And the rebound to Primetime players. Moore into the front court, all the way to the rack, and lays it in. Chris Moore having a big first half. Unofficially 11 points. He may have been credited with that tap, which would give him 13. But already double figures. And we've played only 8 minutes of this game. There's Smorts driving in with the left hand. He missed the shot. Got the rebound. The shot by Mincy in the corner. Back of the iron, but the weak side rebound comes down to Commons. Commons goes inside. And the loose ball picked up by Rutherford. Outlet ahead to Barnett. Barnett, that's a three if it goes. And the rebound, Smith skies for the board. Out to Moore, 4-3. And the ball will go out of bounds back to HBC. This weekend, it's the South Regional here in Atlanta, Georgia. The West Regional in Los Angeles, California. Next weekend, it's the Midwest Regional in Chicago, Illinois. The Northeast Regional in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Winners advancing to the Super 17 Regional in Chicago, Illinois. The ultimate trip to New York, New York. The championship game, winner take all, $1 million prize, will be televised live by ESPN August the 2nd at 3 p.m. Follow away shot, good by Brown. Winnell Brown with four. 6'5", small forward out of Auburn University.
Wait on it,
13-point game. 9 minutes to play, first half. Rutherford out to Smith, 4-3. And Smorts with a rebound. There's Brown, back out to Smorts. He'll hand it off to Mincy. Aaron Mincy out of Merrimack College. He'll try a three, top of the key. Back of the iron. Offensive board for HBC as Wilson went up and got it. And a pass stolen away. Rutherford back the other way. Picked up by Brown. And now Chris Moore will reset. Around a pick set by Foth. Moore in traffic. Good look. Rutherford shot blocked away, though. Good block by Wilson. HBC has numbers the other way. Mincy puts it up. No good, but he draws the foul. And Darren Mincy will shoot two shots. Terrell Smith picks up the personal. That's his first, team first. And Darren Mincy will shoot two shots. First free throw attempts of the game for HBC. Yesterday, 21 points as he drops in the first free throw. He was 7 of 9 for the floor, 4 of 5 from 3-point land, and 3 of 4 from the free throw line in 22 minutes of action. That's his first point in this one. Second free throw on the way, and good. Let's see, 2 for 2. Primetime players, managed by Chris Thomas. Thomas estimates the core of this team has played more than 500 games with one another between the East Coast Basketball League, various pro-ams, and other competitions, winning 100 contests in each one of those seasons. Probably up top for three, no good, and the rebound to HBC. Primetime players scored 64 points in the first half yesterday. Built a 64-37 lead over the number one seed, Team BDB, and just kind of cruised to the victory. This ball picked up by Smith. Smith. Mincy had a hand in his face. Three no good. And Wilson with a rebound. Brown lost the handles on it. It goes out of bounds. However, last touch by the Primetime players. Duncan. Good look inside, but blocked from behind by Pierre Steins. Barnett off to Malachi Jones. Jones has it blocked by Sports, but Evan reaches in, picks up the personal. That's his first, team second. And that will put the former North Carolina State Wolfpack at the free throw line. Malachi Jones looking for his first point of the game. He gets the shooter's roll for his first point. 25-13, 6:55 to play, first half. Front time players from the start leading this one. Second free throw, good again. And the primetime players are playing without their two best bigs, James Dillard the second and Eric Mann. Yesterday, they didn't really need them because of the outside shooting. Mincy, pull-up jumper, and it's no good. Rebounded by Steins. Sanders into the front court. That's Danny Sanders, just checked in. Jones a little bit out of control, and he's gone for traveling. He definitely has the brightest looking shoes out there. It's easy to spot him. Fluorescent colors. Baseline drive, tough shot, good. Well, Brown with six. Under six to play, first half. Barnett backing away. Gets it to Steins. Turnaround shot. Got fouled, and he'll shoot two shots. First foul on Jeremiah Wilson. Pierre Steins, 6'6" power forward out of Clinton Junior College. Yesterday, Steins was 4 of 8 for the floor, finished with 11 points, 3 rebounds, and 12 minutes of action. Count them both. First two of the game for Steins. Six different players have scored for the primetime players. They lead it by 13. Bonet with the right hand, good. 5 points for Steph Bonet. The lead 11. Barnett picked up by Brown. Up top three, Mobley in and out, no good. Steins with a big offensive rebound.
Set back up, Pete, set back up.
And a diving attempt, Brown, did he come up with it? No, we just, good effort though. Not able to save it on the sideline.
Foul, let's go to work.
5 minutes, 12 seconds remaining. First half here from Clayton State University in Atlanta, Georgia. Basketball tournament, South Regional.
Danny, help me out.
Our second bracket championship here on Championship Sunday. Pass inside, well, he does save it, but into the hands of Victor Street Jr., who just checked in.
Hands off!
Duncan reached around, trying to get the ball. Street drives in, misses the shot. Rebounded by HBC. Bonet. Back out. Commons. Got it. Chris Commons with four. 6'8 power forward out of South Carolina Aiken. Street. Goes all the way in, has his shot blocked, but he got it back. And Victor will set it back up. Sanders with a long three. Danny Sanders. He's out of Mars Hill College. Another deep three at the other end. This one good by Chris Thomas. back to single digits. 31-22, 4:03 left in the half. Follow-away shot by Jones, no good. It rolls off. HBC with a rebound. Outlet from Monet to Brown. And the finish at the other end. Quinnell Brown with 8 first half points. It's a 7-point game. Under 4 minutes to play first half. Sanders picked up by Monet. Up top to Stein. Steins cut off. They work it around the perimeter. Street goes inside.
Come on now.
8 seconds on the shot clock. Another deep three. This one rims out for Sanders at HBC. Down 7 with the basketball. Comets over to Brown. Brown, spin move, not able to get free. And a foul called on Streak. That'll be his first. Second team foul against the Primetime Players. Timeout on the floor, 3:06 remaining first half. Let's go listen into the huddle with Chris Thomas and the Primetime Players.
Like we holding the fucking ball. Come down and set the shit up.
Catch it, top it, don't have anything. Swing it.
I mean, shit, come like I say, we just holding. We got to set screens or something. We got to move. We got to fucking move on damn offense, y'all. God. Like I said, and defense. Step up on defense, know where our matchups up. Let's get down here, get a good set, and get a basket.
Hey,
can
I give
it? Let's go, guys. Right now, let's go. Defense on 3. 1, 2, 3. Defense.
Uncensored courtside here at Clayton State University. Bringing you plenty of coaches' sound this week. Hope you've enjoyed it. Two more games to come. At 2:30, no excuses, the 23 seed and Sean Bell All-Stars, the 9 seed, followed by the 15 seed Queen City and the 21 seed Dirty South. That's at 4:15. 4 winners today advancing to the Super 17 Regional in Chicago, Illinois, July 23rd through the 25th. Brown gets it into Commons. Commons picked up by Jones. Commons puts it up with the right hand. No good. The follow also no good. The tap by Brown no good. But the long rebound tracked down by Duncan. Out to Bonet on the wing for 3. And Steph Bonet knocks down his second 3 of the half. He's got 8 first half points. And it's a 4-point game. And we have a fresh 5 to check in for Primetime Players. Jones inside to Steins. Steins having trouble getting a shot off. He'll get it back to Jones, and Malachi will knock it down. First field goal of the game for Malachi Jones. He's got 4, and the lead 6. Winding down near 2 minutes here in the first half. Monet to Brown from the left elbow. 15-footer good. Brown in double figures here in the first half. Back to a 4-point game. Sanders around a pick. Top of the key, 3. No, but it got fouled, and he'll shoot 3 shots. Commons picks up his first foul. Danny Sanders to the foul line to shoot 3 free throws. Sanders 5 for 8 yesterday for the free throw line. Called a violation on that last shot. Free throw by Sanders rolls off, no good. Sanders misses again. Here comes 4 of those Primetime Players. Starters back on the floor. Sanders hits 1 of 3.
Let's
He'll sub for him as well. So, again, the original starting five back on the floor. .34-29, five-point game. Bonet cut off. Outside to Brown. Ball fake into the corner. Here is Smorts for three, and that one goes over the top. Back to the primetime players. Smorts was a 38% three-point shooter at the University of Maryland. Nearing a minute and a half to play. First half, Rutherford for three. Got another one. That's his third three of the first half. He's in double figures with 11. And they stretch the lead out to eight. Bonet's pass is knocked away. That's a late whistle, but a foul is called. Probably the right call. We'll be on Donald Rutherford. That's his first team third. So Brown will throw it in on the baseline. Brown into Duncan. Duncan for three over Moore. The tap no good by Smorts. Outlet ahead to Moore. Moore, cross-court pass. Barnett for three. And the rebound to Smorts. Smorts to Brown. Brown stolen away by Smith, but he ran out of real estate. And will remain with HBC. 61 seconds left in the half. 37-29, primetime players. Aaron Duncan setting up the play. And Smorts called for traveling. Seconds left, first half. Chance to take a double-digit lead.
Got plenty of time.
Rutherford. Follow-away shot. Missed the bank. Smorts with a rebound. Duncan will bring it up. And the shot clock is turned off. So HBC can play for the final shot here in the first half. Duncan now with 10 seconds left. 5 seconds left. Brown got bumped. Back out to Duncan for three. And that's the end of the first half. Primetime players will head to the locker room with an 8-point lead. Our score at the end of one is the Primetime players 37, HBC 29. We'll take and Dirty Sound. Primetime basketball to begin the second half. Barnett to Smith, out to Moore. Moore, follow-away shot with Bonet's hand in his face. Good defense, Bonet gets the rebound. Duncan left, to the front left. Court. Bonet outside for three, rims off, and the rebound to Barnett. Rutherford in the paint, little up and under move. Yes, he got it. 15 for Donald Rutherford. And the primetime players take a double-digit lead. In the first half, they led by 15 points. HBC had a brief lead, a three-point lead, about a minute and a half in. Three in the corner. Good. By Quinnell Brown. That's his first shot behind the arc. 13 for Brown. Brown out of Auburn University. Back to single digits. Moore around the pick. Out to Barnett. Barnett, follow-away shot is no good. Rebound to Bonet. Bonet, alley-oop, deflected, but saved. Into the corner, three on the way, good by Jeremiah Wilson. That's his fourth three of the game. There's Commons for three. And the ball knocked out of bounds by Wilson. Shot in the paint, an air ball, and Duncan comes away with it after this by Pfaff. Bonet passed up a three, decided to go inside, and he finds Commons. That's 9 points for Chris Commons. And let's see what we got here. A hand check foul called. This will be on Quinnell Brown. That's his second. First team foul of the second half. Non-shooting foul. Moore gets it in. Moore gets it back. Moore to Smith as he backs it out. Pfaff hands it off to Barnett. Barnett inside the arc. And the rebound to HBC. Duncan lost it, but Bonet there to pick it up. Commons.
Under.
Spin move, cut off of the baseline, and has it stolen away. The defense by Sean Barnett. Outlet pass deflected, but saved by Moore, and he lays it in. Chris Moore with 11. One of two players in double figures for primetime. 44-37. Layup good and a foul. Count the basket for Quinnell Brown. So he's at the line for a 3-point play the old school way. Foul called on Terrell Smith. That's his second.
What's up, Black?
And Brown converts the 3-point play. Smith. And a wraparound foul on Commons. Terrell Smith saying, we got to get moving. We're stagnant. Barnett to Rutherford. Rutherford had it stripped, but he was able to get enough inside to Pfaff. They save the possession. Plenty of time on the shot clock, 16 seconds. A three from up top, short by Smith. Rebounded by Bonet. Outlet to Mincy. Mincy lays it up. And it blocked by Moore. A 6'1" point guard went up and got a big block. 44-40, a 4-point game. Moore back out on the wing. Smith for three. Yes! First basket of the game for Terrell Smith. 6'3 shooting guard out of Limestone College. Back to a 7-point game, just under 13 minutes to play. A spot in Chicago, Illinois at stake. Smorts going to drive in, and he bumps in. Well, let's see. I think they called the foul up top before he knocked down Rutherford. In fact, that's what they did. They're going to call it on Chris Moore.
Turn around. Let's go. Turn around. We're good.
That'll be his first. Second team foul. Non-shooting foul. Inbounds pass to Bonet. Quick catch and shoot. Got it. Stemponet now in double figures with 10. It's a five-point game, 12:40 to play here in Atlanta, Georgia. For the basketball tournament, South Regional. One of two regionals this weekend, the other in Los Angeles, California for the West Regional. That's an offensive foul. Thomas Pfaff picks up his first foul. Pfaff out of Lipscomb University.
Let's go, Blast. Get a stop.
Member of the Blast. Atlantic Sun stop. Conference. We've seen a bunch of Atlantic Sun Conference players in this tournament. Mercer, Florida Gulf Coast, Stetson.
Left, right.
Bonet with the right hand and the rebound to Moore. Moore pushing it up. Hands it off to Barnett. Barnett over to Rutherford. Rutherford. Now back up top to Barnett. The defense by HBC. Barnett for three. Got it. Sean Barnett with five. And it's an eight-point advantage for the primetime players. Under 12 minutes to play. Sports for three. Former Maryland Terp can't hit the three. And a chance to go back up double digits again. Smith for three, comes up short. Smorts with a rebound. Smorts back the other way. Mincy, finger roll to the hole. And he's got four, his first field goal of the game. It's a six-point game, 50-44. Our second good game, as we knew they would be here on Championship Day. Championship Sunday. Here at the South Regional. Comets thought about a three. Instead, we'll get the Mincy for three. Mincy comes up short. Long rebound. Goes out of bounds. Last touch by HBC. Malachi Jones will check back in. The former North Carolina State Wolfpack. We have a timeout on the floor. 10:53 remaining in the game. Let's check in with Chris Thomas and the Primetime Players Huddle. Sean Barnett and Malachi Jones just talking about what they want to do. 10:53 to play. Primetime Players with a six-point lead, 50-44. Barnett picked up by Smorts. Barnett with a hand in his face. Smorts at 6'10 on the 6'4 Barnett. And they throw it away. Duncan's pass stolen right back. Picked off by Smith. Rutherford into the front court. Off to Jones. Malachi back out. Rutherford now over to Smith. Smith picked up by Mincy. He'll shoot a three with a hand in his face. No good. He missed it badly and rebounded by HBC. Outlet ahead to Duncan. Duncan down the lane. Feeds it off. Collins missed the layup. Got it back. Follow shot no good, but he got fouled from behind. We'll be on Sean Barnett. That's his first. That's the 14th foul against the Primetime Players. Chris Collins will shoot two shots, looking to get into double figures. He has 9 points today.
Get gone. Yeah.
sorry. My apologies. Understanding that it's actually pronounced Smotrits. Sometimes you need to go ask the players because the coaches a lot of times don't know. I asked the coach directly. I said, calling Smorts. Maybe that's what they call him, is Smorts, because sometimes those guys' names you can't pronounce. And they give them acronyms or abbreviations. So my apologies, I've been calling it Smorts. It is Smotrits. .45, 9:49 to play. Steins for three, comes up short. Jones with a big rebound. They keep it alive. A three outside, no good by Mobley. The follow good underneath. Malachi Jones with six. 52-45, 9:23 to play. Ball picked up by Jones. Barnett for three. That rim's in and out, no good. Smotrits with a rebound. Outlet to Duncan. Duncan for three. And the tip good by Jeremiah Wilson. .52-47. 5-point lead for Prime Time. Under 9 minutes to play in the game. And a foul call on the rebound will go against Darren Duncan. He didn't like the call. That'll be his first. Fourteen foul. The bounce pass for Moore. To Barnett. Up top to Jones. Over to Moore. Moore. Back out. Barnett for three. Steins with an offensive rebound. And another quick shot by Mobley. Chance to close the gap. Duncan saves it to Wilson. And rims out. And Mobley with a rebound. Out with a head to Moore. Moore in the paint. Can't get it to go down. Loose ball. Taken away by Smotrich. Out with the Brown. Brown lays it up and in. Quinnell Brown. With eight in the second half, 18 for the game, 52-49, 3-point game with 7:31 to play. Strip and a steal. Smotrich with the outlet down the floor to Mincy, and Mincy. Looks like he had his shot partially blocked there by Mobley, who got back defensively. Tough shot. Moore can't get it to go down. The tap no good. Tap down and rebounded by HBC. Brown back the other way. Brown in the paint. Dishes over left side to Duncan, who lays it in. First points of the game for Darren Duncan. And a timeout called with 6:52 to play. It's a one-point game. 52-51. Let's check in once again with Chris Thomas and the Primetime Players Huddle.
Chris, got you for 1 second. Get your answer. You right back here. Hey, guys, hey, we just got to finish in the basket. We got to be able to finish, guys.
Hang out down here too much. You got to get back.
Let's go, yes, right?
That's how they got in the game.
First play, we got to get a basket here, then we got to get a stop.
Hey, Chris, on the one. Hey, Chris, bring it up.
He out for a set. He out for just a set. Soon, okay. But when he came back here, put him in there.
We got guys all around.
Chris. When we come back, go back to the one. Go to the one. Let Sean go off. Let's go.
One, two, three.
Defense.
Hey, you gotta have the ball.
Yeah.
He can't play without the ball with Sean on the board. Sean on the board.
6:52 remaining. A trip to DePaul University in Chicago, Illinois at stake. The 2015 Super 17, which will be July 23rd through the 25th. The winners of each of the four regionals, the South Regional here in Atlanta, the West Regional in Los Angeles, California, and then the Midwest Regional in Chicago, Illinois next week, and the Northeast Regional in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania also next week, all will advance to the Super 17 Regional, trying to get to the championship in New York, New York. It'll be televised August 2nd, 3 o'clock by ESPN. Primetime players holding on by one. They've led by double digits. In fact, in the first half, they led by 15. Smith to Jones. Malachi in the paint. Trying to get it to Mobley, but he threw it behind him out of bounds. HBC with a chance to take the lead.
Turn around, let's go.
Counting down to the 6 minute.
Watch it down, Pete.
Wilson got fouled and he'll shoot two. Foul call on Pierre Steins, that's his first. 15 foul. Wilson out of Tarleton State. And it can't get the roll. 6 points today for the 6'9" power forward. Danny Sanders will check in. Mobley will check out. Also checking back in is Chris Moore. Barnett will check out. Wilson set for his second free throw. A chance to tie. Missed them both. Moore with a rebound. Moore racing into the front court. Cut off by Bonet. In the corner, Smith for three. And the rebound tracked down by HBC's Steph Bonet. 52-51, HBC with a chance to take the lead. They haven't led since early in the first half. Step back three by Bonet. Rims out, no good. Rebound to Sanders. HBC, under 5.5 to play, up by one. Inside to Steins. Steins, turnaround shot, no good. Rebounded by Malachi Jones. Let's see what's the call. We have a foul on the floor. Substitution as Rutherford will check in for Steins. Steph Bonet picked up that last personal. That's his first. Each team with 5 team fouls. Inbounds pass to Sanders. Sanders. Smith. Back up top three. Good. Danny Sanders with his first points of the second half. Sanders out of Mars Hill College. It's a 4-point game. With under 5 to play. Bonet drives in. Puts it up off the glass. Good. Steph Bonet with 12 points. 4.5. It's a 2-point game. 55-53. Both games coming down to the... Well, the last game came down to the final seconds. Overseas Elite held on to win 73-68. Over Train to Go. Whistle and a foul. This will be on HBC. Quinnell Brown picks up his third personal. A non-shooting foul. 16 foul. One more. They will be in the bonus and at the free throw line. Bounce pass to Sanders. Deep three. Got it. 10 points for Sanders. His third three of the game. 58-53. That's a prime time play by the prime time player. Bonet drives in, puts it high in the air. Good, and a foul. A chance for a three-point play the old school way for Steph Bonet. Foul on Donald Rutherford. That'll be his second. And Bonet misses the free throw. Former North Carolina State Wolfpack Malachi Jones got the rebound. Now saved to Smith. Another deep three from up top. That one missed badly by Sanders. HBC comes away with it. Bonet around the pick. Splits defenders. Kicks it back up top. They work it around the perimeter. Three on the way. Rimming no good for Wilson. The follow also no good. And Smith with a rebound. Outlet ahead to Moore. Moore quickly in the front court. Splitting defenders. Puts the shot up. An air ball no good. He saves it though. Sanders picked up the loose ball. And then the ball went off the foot, I believe, of Sanders. It looks like it went out of bounds. So a timeout on the floor. Let's keep it right here. Once again, let's go to the primetime players huddle with the general manager and coach, Chris Thomas.
Cash out. You got to. Hey, we're going to start trapping that team from getting in there. We're going to trap. You might as well bang it because, like I said, they're not calling shit. Go ahead and give a chance. Go ahead and fucking bump him. Get him the fuck out of there. Go ahead and bump him. Get it out of there. Now let's go. Come on.
It's about talking on me. We can switch even. Just don't let him get a trip. Bam.
Yeah. Come on. Let's go.
Hit one.
Defense on three. One, two, three.
Hey, don't fight.
Once again, our uncensored coverage into the huddle. One of the advantages when you're not on live TV. 3:27 to play in the basketball game. 58-55. Primetime players, the 19th seed, leading the 11th seed, HBC. Well, it was brothers Brian and Chris Hurley of Watertown, Massachusetts, who drove with their dad down to Philadelphia for the basketball tournament last year. They were so intrigued that they decided to form the Hurley Basketball Club, HBC. Both were college basketball players. Brothers had never had the chance to play alongside each other and really kind of jumped at the opportunity that the basketball tournament presented to make that dream a reality. Bill Jones is the coach, but he had a conflict. He's coaching a team in Canada. He'll be back if they can make it to Chicago. Chris Hurley is the acting coach today. So not playing. 58-55. Duncan with it. Picked up by Smith. Top of the key three. Bonet for the tie. Back of the iron, no good. And the ball will go out of bounds back to the primetime players. Winding down our second championship bracket game. Up next, No Excuses and Sean Bell All-Stars. Rutherford trying to muscle his way in there, tapped it up, no good, and Duncan with a rebound.
I got two on the side.
A three will tie it. Open look, Brown, his three, no good. And rebounded by Smotrich, deflected by Sanders, diving to the floor, loose ball. What do we got? And they say that Sanders was out of bounds on the baseline, but what a great effort by both those young men. That's what $1 million will make you do. You give it all you got.
Let's go.
2:23 and counting. HBC down three, 58-55. Duncan directing traffic. We have a whistle away from the basketball. And it's a foul on Terrell Smith. That's the third on Smith. And that will put Commons at the line. That's a 17 foul. A 1-1 for Chris Commons. Commons 2-for-2 from the line today. Commons played at South Carolina Aiken. First free throw is good. Second free throw, good again. It's a one-point game, 58-57. Primetime players holding on, trying to get to Chicago, Illinois for the Super 17. Two minutes remaining. Smith in the corner. Step back and knocks down the three. Second three in the second half for Terrell Smith out of Limestone College. It's a four-point lead for the Primetime players. 1:40 left. Duncan picked up by Smith. And the pass almost stolen away. Another good effort by Danny Sanders. He has really given him some good minutes, particularly on defense, but he's also hit some threes here in the second half. Rutherford will check out. Bounce pass to Duncan. Now over to Bonet. And Bonet gets fouled with 1:23 to play.
Chris.
This will be on Malachi Jones. That's his first.
Show.
18th foul.
Off the ball.
That's Bonet. At the line for a 1-1. 14 today for the 5'10" point guard. And Bonet hits the first free throw. Makes it a three-point game.
Box out. 61-58.
Second free throw on the way and good again. Bonet got them both to make it a two-point game. 1:20 to play here in Atlanta, Georgia. 61-59. Moore beats it off to Barnett. Barnett picked up by Smotrich. Barnett drives in and draws the foul. The former Maryland Terp picks up his second foul. And that will put Barnett at the free throw line. That's a 17th foul committed by HBC. Sean Barnett has not attempted a free throw today. Barnett out of Wingate University. And his free throw is good. 6 points for Barnett, matching his uniform number. 62-59 with 66 seconds to play. Second one rims off. Smotrich with a rebound. Baseline drive, reverse layup, no good. Rebounded by Steins. 4 picked up by Bonet. Off to Smith. 40 seconds left. They will have to put up a shot. Driving in, Barnett missed the shot. Stein's got the offensive rebound. The follow shot no good, but he got fouled by Smotrich. Somehow Steins at 6'6 was able to get inside against the big 6'10 Smotrich. And that will be the third foul on Evan Smotrich. And let's go to the team huddle. It looks like the primetime players want a timeout. Oh, actually, Stein says he's okay, but Now they are going to use a timeout. Let's go back to the huddle.
They said he needed it.
Yeah,
because fuck it. Yeah, he has to shoot. Oh. I got 130. That's last. I got one full. I got one full left.
We're going to need it. If anybody hits two, we're going to get a stop. Game over.
Let's go.
Defense on three. One, two, three. Defense. Don't foul, shooter.
I think that timeout, more or less, to try to give Pierre Stein a little bit of rest, as he was a little shaken up, but he said he was okay. And you heard the clarification on how many timeouts they had left. With 31 seconds to play, it's a three-point lead for the primetime players.
Hey.
And Pierre Stein's at the line, the former Clinton Junior College player, 6'6", power forward, with a chance to add to a three-point lead. Stein's 2 for 2 for the line today. That's his third point. 4-point lead. And he gets them both. 5-point lead for the primetime players. Duncan into the front court, calls timeout. 28 seconds left. We'll go back to the primetime players
let's
huddle.
Let's go, guys. Let's go.
Listen,
hey, they're hedging high.
Listen, front of them on the three. Hey, my five.
Here,
we're
guys.
Switching everything. All right, push up.
We can give up.
Oh,
hell no.
Screen and roll, we're switching everything.
So everybody switching
everything.
Don't get caught with fucking jumping into him.
He is a great defender, so he can switch and go on
the ground. Hey, don't let them catch you in the fucking air either now. Let's go. Keep your feet.
Hedge on the pick and switch it.
Okay, let's go. Let's go. One, two, three.
Defense. Let's go.
Let's stop.
28 seconds. Once again, more uncensored coverage from the huddle. 64-59. Primetime players by 5. Overseas Elite pulled it out 73-68 over Train to Go. They didn't take their first lead until there were 3 minutes and 42 seconds to play in the game. But it's not how you start, it's how you finish. And Overseas Elite, our first team of the day to advance to the Super 17 Regional. Bonet will throw it in.
Let's make a run set that clock, Black. Let's make a run set that clock.
Inbounds pass to Duncan. You don't have to have a three here, but if you get a two, you need to get in a hurry. They do look for a three. Wide open look in the corner. The shot no good by Brown. And Primetime comes away with it. Morgan's fouled at midcourt with 12.8 seconds to play. The Primetime players are about to head to Chicago. And the fans loving it on their feet behind me. Duncan picked up his second foul. Chris Moore at the line for a 1-1. Moore has not attempted a free throw shot today. Chris Moore out of Charleston Southern. Moore now with 12. 65-59. Moore gets the boat. And it's stolen away! And that will put the final nail in the coffin. The primetime players are headed to the Super 17 Regional as they defeat HBC. The 19 seed knocks off the 11 seed, 66-59.